whoLives.org already has a drill that they use called the Village Drill, and it works really well. It's just, it's really big.
One of the main reasons we went back to BYU was to make it small enough that it would fit in the back end of a bus. It would reduce the transportation costs by almost 90% if we could do that.
A big challenge for our team this year was trying to look at the Village Drill and take the pieces that were working well from that design, but adding or taking away things to make our drill more appropriate for more remote locations. So the way our drill works is we have these handles on the top where people stand and use our arms to put in power. That power is transferred down through our swivel and through our drill string and then to the bit at the bottom, which actually does the cutting. And then we have the structure around it to stabilize everything, and that structure goes into the ground.
One of the most innovative things that they came up with was the ability to drill by pulling down as opposed to pushing down. And that one little idea changed everything. So our first trip over with our new Village Drill, we went to Uganda. We brought the entire drill over in our carry-on luggage.
Having a structure that was small enough that we could transport it, but also large enough and robust enough that it could handle those forces was a really difficult trade-off.
They've come up with a great partner for the Village Drill, something that's smaller, even more portable, which we thought would be impossible, but still maintain all its strength.
Where I'm from, Ghana, there are many places without access to clean water. And so to be able to work on this project, to be able to do something that for me is very personal, and also that I have the ability to be able to develop a drill that makes their living standards, you know, higher than it was before, something that I think is cool, and I really love that.